This is Vivica Williams, and you're watching Head to Head. Today, we're talking about the activity of trade unions in Ukraine. Recently, the Ukrainian Institute for Democracy and Social Progress conducted a survey to find out the opinions and knowledge of Ukrainians when it comes to trade unions. The results were quite intriguing. So to talk with them about them today, we welcome to the studio political analyst Bogdan Ferenc. Hello, and thank you for joining us today.
Hello, Vivica.
So first off, tell us, what is the significance today of trade unions? Because I think many people see them as something antiquated or something that's no longer needed, especially maybe our viewers in the U.S. or some other countries. So tell us about the significance of trade unions for Ukraine.
You know, in theoretical aspects, the role of trade union is very important, especially when we are talking about the social reforming processes, especially in the context of association agreement between Ukraine and the EU. When we are talking about the conditions, when we have these conditions at our workplace, that's why in theoretical aspect, trade unions are really important part of this social cohesion between the working people and the employees.
Right, absolutely.
But in reality, yeah, unfortunately, it's quite difficult for the majority of Ukrainians to see that our Ukrainian trade unions are really influence a lot on the process in this context. But we know the experience of the European Union, and especially in this regard, we conducted as an Institute for Democracy and Social Progress international conference, and the European experience of implementing, of advocating and lobbying in positive way the working rights is very crucial for us.
So then you're trying to make sure that the trade unions in Ukraine have some of the same characteristics as what you find in Europe and stay relevant and actually work practically.
Yeah, not in a theoretical dimension, but in practical life. I can say that our international conference, the issue was the cooperation between trade unions and political parties. We invited the experts from Sweden, from Belgium, from other countries, and these experts shared with us that this kind of cooperation is very needed. You know why? Because in Ukraine, for trade unions, they are not able to prepare, they can prepare some legislation, draft laws, for example, but they are not able to pass these draft laws. That's why they need this cooperation with political parties. But as you know, in Ukraine, it's quite difficult to say that we have ideologically based political parties. And from this point of view, for us as a think tank, it was necessary to develop, to discover what kind of frame of cooperation could be between trade unions and political parties, and what European experience we can implement in our reality.
And so what were some of the findings that you got from this?
We prepared, by the way, because we sought the organizers. By the way, our co-organizers were the Foundation for European Progressive Studies. This foundation is founded by the and financed by the European Parliament, and the other one is a foundation for Max van der Stoel from Netherlands. And with this support, we were able to invite more than 155 representatives from different trade unions, by the way, from different NGOs and political parties. And the discussion sometimes was quite, you know, emotional,
of course,
because we have some clashes maybe between trade unions, federation and independent. But I think it was really productive for the young people, because from our survey, by the way, we've just prepared and we received some figures, more than 1,500 representatives from different regions took part in our surveys. And for young people, this topic of trade unions is quite boring.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the results of the survey. So the people who were surveyed, this was a mix of younger, older, working, the typical mix for a survey class. So what were the overall findings about what people thought about trade unions?
First and main important things are our respondents, they are active people, because we asked them, are you really active in the non-governmental sector?
And so, like, they, volunteers?
Yeah,
or
they answered that more than 85% percentage of these people, they are really active. Mm-hmm. That's why for them the topic of trade unionism maybe is much more closer than for others, for the majority of Ukrainians.
So it was a very specific survey. This wasn't general population, but it was a particular survey of respondents?
Of respondents, and we used Facebook, mm-hmm. and online platform, because we were quite limited in our resources. For real sociological research, we were not able to provide this. But in this context, we just received quite interesting figures that I can share a few of them. By the way, more than 49% of the representatives of different NGOs consider the trade unions as an effective association, but more in a theoretical frame. But 39% of respondents consider that this is not so productive association, and maybe some heritage from the Soviet Union is influenced on their activities, or the activities of trade unions.
Hmm. And what about student trade unions? Is this seen in a different light than work-related trade unions?
I think it depends on the universities, especially because in quite progressive universities, students' trade unions are very active. Mm-hmm. I personally know a lot of young leaders from the trade union movements, and they are really active. They are preparing some interesting initiatives. They advocate and they write student rights. But in some not so progressive universities, the leaders of these trade unions are quite old. They are not willing to do some reforming, you know, to make some good activities. That's why I personally and my colleagues, as we have some possibilities, we are trying to work with really progressive trade unions, with young people, and teach them how they can provide the communication, for example. Because from our survey, mm-hmm. there are a lot of a big lack of communication between trade unions and broader audience. Mm-hmm. You know, they are living in their own atmosphere.
Exactly. This can be an issue when trade unions stop really representing the people they're supposed to represent. So this is one of the things that your organization tries to work with, is to try to keep trade unions relevant and connected.
We have Institute for Democracy and Social Progress, an ISDE platform. I'm a founder of this movement. We have some experience in communication, sharing the experience from our European partners in our Ukrainian realities. And we are open to share this experience. And we are happy that some of different trade unions, they are willing to get this experience and to get this knowledge, because they understand that it's really necessary. And unfortunately, sometimes trade unions are feeling a lot of pressure too in the political context, because a lot of political parties would like to use the resource of trade unions, you know, and it's not a good point for making the cooperation.
So what are some of the pressures or some of the issues you've seen that trade unions are getting pressured on from the political side?
Yeah, because when trade unions, you know, it's some kind unique association information. They are always trying to fight. If you would like to get a better conditions, for example, a better salary, higher salary, you should to fight. You have to fight, you know, in the proper way.
Right.
That's why it depends a lot of the owners of enterprises, of the owners of political parties, because a big business and political parties, they are quite connected, close in our Ukrainian realities. That's why when some, for example, miners, because now I heard a lot about some problems with salary in industrial regions with, mm-hmm. with miners, and they are willing to change the situation in a better way. Mm-hmm. They need this association. They need to be heard more, you know, because it's really a problem. And I hope that with our research, with our experience, trade unions in Ukraine will do better in the advocating the worker rights.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for being with us today and for giving us this insight into trade unions. And what, before we go, what do you see some of the next steps in this coming year or in the next, the process of developing trade unions? What do you see happening in the next year?
What I can say, and I hope really, is that now more and more young leaders are emerging in the trade union movements. Mm-hmm. And we are willing that these young leaders will cooperate between each other. It doesn't depend from what trade union you are. These trade unions and some political parties, they have common goals, you know, mm-hmm. to do in a proper way the social reforms in Ukraine. That's why I hope, from my point of view, that these new emerged leaders inside the trade union movements and political parties will be able to cooperate, to create some practical initiatives on the ground in different regions, and to strengthen the social sphere in Ukraine.
These are very good goals, and I hope they're gonna. Hope you're gonna see this develop. It seems like your organization's really trying to help this happen.
Yeah, if we have some possibilities, why not? We have to share these opportunities with others.
Thank you so much for being with us today, Bogdan.
Thank you for the invitation.
And this was Bogdan Ferenc, political analyst. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for more.